I don't usually conduct a lot of clinical trials. I usually look at clinical trials from two different from another perspective, because what I see sometimes as a palliative care physician, that there is too emphasis on clinical trials, and sometimes it can delay some of the important discussion because we're chasing clinical trial after the other. Clinical trial is still trial, so we don't know if this medication is going to work or not. We're hoping to have more clinical trials so we understand better the cancer, but at the end we're still conducting experiment. We're trying to understand. So there is no guarantee that this medication would work. And depends on the clinical trial also. There is different levels of trial. There is the introductory phase one, which also a lot of times trying to examine novel medication, and the focus of these clinical trials actually into finding the right dose. So it's not looking actually if it's helping the cancer or not. It's looking into, is this medication safe to be used in human being or not? And what's the right dose? And what's the side effects? So sometimes there is this misunderstanding about what are some of the risks, which I try to help my patient in understanding. What does clinical trial mean? What are some of the risks? And why, in addition to exploring the clinical trial, we also should have a backup plan. I would like to make sure that I give you the best treatment possible, and we'd like to get you in the best shape possible, but also knowing the cancer, we know that sometimes things can decline or can change quite quickly, and we need to make sure that we have a safety net.